Welcome to St. John's Episcopal Church on this dreary day in Maryland. Those of us who would normally come and join us in our parking lot drive-in and are staying home, please stay home and stay safe. Our annual meeting is postponed until February 28th. And if there is anyone that would like to put the 34th as well to serve on the vestry, please contact me or Michelle Lozanski, our senior warden. This morning, we will be using Rite 2 on page 323. And as we gather and prepare for worship, let us sing our hymn, Songs of Thankful Praise. Oh, one moment.
Rite 1.
Rite 1. Did I say Rite 2?
You did.
Oh, my word.
We're all.
It's the icy rain and the weather outside. We will be using Rite 1. Thank you for catching that, Liz, on page 323. And as we gather for worship, let us prepare our hearts as we sing songs of thankfulness and praise.
Thank you.
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But
those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray Psalm 147 in unison.
Hallelujah!
How good is it to sing praises to our God. How pleasant it is to honor him with praise. The Lord rebuilds Jerusalem. He gathers exiles of Israel. He heals brokenhearted and binds up their wounds.
He counts the numbers of the stars
and calls upon them by their names.
Great is our Lord and mighty in power. There is no limit to his judgment.
The Lord lifts up the lowly and casts the wicked to the ground.
Sing to the Lord with thanksgiving.
Make music to our God on harp.
He covers the heavens with clouds
and prepares rain for the earth.
He makes grass to grow on the mountains
and green plants to serve mankind. He provides food for flocks and herds and for the young ravens when they cry. He is not impressed by the might of a horse. He has no pleasure in the strength of a man. But the Lord has pleasure in those who fear him, in those who await his gracious favor. Hallelujah. A reading from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians. If I proclaim the gospel, this gives me no ground for boasting, for an obligation is laid on me, and woe to me if I do not proclaim the gospel. For if I do this of my own will, I have a reward. But if not of my own will, I am entrusted with a commission. What then is my reward? Just this, that in my proclamation I may make the gospel free of charge, so as not to make full use of my rights to the gospel. For though I am free with respect to all, I have made myself a slave to all, so that I might win more of them. To the Jews I became as a Jew in order to win Jews. To those under the law, I became as one under the law, though I myself am not under the law, so that I might win those under the law. To those outside the law, I became as one outside the law, though I am not free from God's law, but am under Christ's law, so that I might win those outside the law. To the weak, I became weak, so that I might win the weak. I have become all things to all people, that I might by all means save some. I do it all for the sake of the gospel, so that I may share in its blessings. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
To you, Lord Christ.
After Jesus and his disciples left the synagogue, they entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Now Simon's mother-in-law was in bed with a fever, and they told him about her at once. And he came and took her by the hand and lifted her up. Then the fever left her, and she began to serve them. That evening, at sundown, they brought to him all who were sick or possessed with demons. And the whole city was gathered around the door. And he cured many who were sick with various diseases and cast out many demons. And he would not permit the demons to speak because they knew him. In the morning, while it was still very dark, he got up and went out to a deserted place. And there he prayed. And Simon and his companions hunted for him. And when they found him, they said to him, "Everyone is searching for you." And he answered, "Let us go on to the neighboring towns, so that I may proclaim the message there also. For that is what I came out to do." And and he went throughout Galilee proclaiming the message in their synagogues and casting out demons. The Gospel of Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
I speak in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Jesus did give us a template, after all, on how to pray. And if you know it, say it with me. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
They are restored fully into that community and into their role. But for this morning, I would invite us to reflect on the importance of prayer as we work and proclaim the good news of Jesus and of his kingdom. I'm going to invite you into my mindset, into the lives of priests and pastors. Because it certainly has been an interesting 11 months serving as a priest in Christ's holy and apostolic church. I know I can speak confidently for many of my colleagues, and that overnight we have to figure
to stream our worship services online. Moments of envy came to a head as we knew of other churches and denominations who have already been live streaming their services or had all the technological resources and our teams at the tip of their fingers. As the months went on, there was an underlying current of competition of who could have the best stream worship or who was the most innovative. And when churches, both Episcopal and other denominations, began to regather, the air of who is doing it the best reared its head. When the Diocese of Maryland suspended in-person gatherings last November due to the rising numbers of positivity rates, case rates, hospitalizations, and deaths, many cried out as they watched their fellow brothers and sisters in Christ gather for worship in their respective denominations, while others remained grateful for being cautious. And in our stress and grief about how we do church, have we forgotten what it means to be church, to proclaim the good news, to be prayerful in how to do that? Have we been preoccupied by what we want ourselves to be as church, as opposed to prayerfully discerning who God is calling us to become? Remember, gathering for worship is only one part of being church. Community is important, and indeed many of us are grieving that we are unable to do so in the ways that we have done in the past. But coming to church on Sunday for about an hour and a half, 2 hours, does not define who we are as church. This isn't unique to our current situation, though. Prior to the pandemic, ideas of if we just had a praise band, people would come. We need young families so the church will go on after I die, so we need to go and get those young families. Or we need a youth group, so let's start a youth group to bring in the youth, are some of the things that come to mind which I have heard. However, at St. John's, how many people here play the electric guitar, bass, drums, and play keyboard, well, aside from dancing? Are we here at St. John's only focused on young families that would keep our church going? Or the question, if we're going to start a youth group, well, we kind of need youth to do that, and we have very few at St. John's. And we see other churches with these ministries and think that is the magic key to be successful as a church. And the mentality of keeping up with the Joneses down the street can be crippling. And again, the question to ask is, have you prayerfully discerned, prayerfully discerned, that this is what St. John's ministry should look like? Or is it a panic reaction, a fearful reaction, and not trusting God, that God has perhaps something more wonderful and incredible and life-giving ministries to offer to our community? And it can also be said for past ministries that we need to continue X ministry because it was so special and fruitful for so many years. Nostalgia is a powerful drug and can both hinder and suppress what God might be calling us to do. And when we enter those times of nostalgia, are we really praying in discerning that is what God calls us to do in preaching the kingdom? Or have we let that powerful drug of nostalgia take over? We see in our lesson today that early in the morning, Jesus got up and went to a secluded place to pray. And when his disciples found him, he said, "Let us go. Let us go into the neighboring towns so that I may proclaim the message." Prayer. Go. Proclaim. Prayer. Go. Proclaim. Jesus spent time in prayer before going out to proclaim the good news. And if we see truly Jesus as our leader, as our shepherd, who leads by example, we too should emulate this in our ministries as we discern how to go forward at St. John's, to pray, and in the prayer, to discern, to go, and to proclaim. Now, Jesus' mission was specific. He inaugurated the kingdom of God, and he redeemed the world through his passion. And prayer had a vital role in his mission, as you see throughout the Gospels and throughout his life and his ministry. And as a church, we are called to proclaim the good news that we have in Jesus. Jesus' example of doing all things in and through prayer is how we too should approach all things in our ministries. When we approach our ministries, whether here at St. John's or outside in the world, do we pray with a discerning heart, listening to how God might be calling us to serve? Or do we approach our ministries with earthly barometers, with how many numbers we can grab in our pews and in our church, with the crowds that we have at St. John's for various ministries and outreach? The question is it God or is it our agenda when we prayerfully discern the ministries? And if we are acting and serving our community for ourselves, or to keep up with the Joneses down the road, then we have truly missed the mark of the work of the church, and that it is prayerful, and that it is discerning God's ministry for us as we serve Him in our community. And so as we continue to work for the kingdom, let us be prayerful. Let us open ourselves to God's Spirit and allow Him to guide us in our ministries. Let us prayerfully discern the kind of church Jesus is calling us to be. We all have our ideas of what church should be in our world. But does that should align up with God's calling and God's will? And so in order to transform the world in the radical way Jesus calls us, we need to be prayerful. And that includes us at this time as we are unable to gather in community. Let us continue to be prayerful at home and to discern how God might be calling St. John's to serve. Let us not compare ourselves in the way we are ministering at this time with others. Let us not get caught up in that earthly agenda, but let us focus on Jesus and His calling for us. Jesus prayed when He was tempted. Jesus prayed in the morning before he began his work to bring the good news. Jesus prayed and there was enough food to feed 5,000 men. Jesus prayed in the garden saying, "Your will be done." John. Does that sound familiar from what we have in the Lord's Prayer? Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Jesus prayed for those who persecuted him while he was dying on the cross, and Jesus prayed with his disciples after his resurrection. Prayer. In prayer, Jesus accomplished all things for God's kingdom. And imagine the ways we could transform our community if we choose to prayerfully discern the ways God is calling us to proclaim the gospel. So, my friends, let us pray. Amen. Brothers and sisters, I would invite you to join me as we affirm our faith with the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, one with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again. Accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The prayers of the people may be found on page 328 of the Book of Common Prayer. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church and the world. Almighty and ever-living God, who made thy holy word, has taught us to make prayers and supplications, and to give thanks for all men. Receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thee, divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant all that those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, especially for the most reverend Justice Welby, Archbishop of Canterbury, and for the Most Reverend Michael Curry, our presiding bishop, for the Right Reverend Eugene Sutton, our bishop, and for the Right Reverend Robert Eloff, our assistant bishop, for our rector, Reverend Elizabeth Cycles, for the wardens, the vestry, the staff, and all members and friends of St. John's Church. And to all thy people, give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. We beseech thee also to rule the hearts of those who bear the authority of government in this and every land, especially for Joseph, our president, for Larry, our governor, Brandon, John, and Mary, who lead our city and counties, that they may be led to wise decisions and right actions for the welfare and peace of the world. Open, O Lord, the eyes of all people to behold thy gracious hand in all thy works, that rejoicing in thy whole creation, they may honor thee with their substance and be faithful stewards of thy bounty. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity, remembering those in our hearts either silently or aloud. And we bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, and beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to grant us grace so to follow the good examples of Saint John and of all thy saints, that with them we may be partakers of thy holy heavenly kingdom. Grant these our prayers, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Amen.
In Christ there is no hope.
Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, we thy people do celebrate and make with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming again with power and great glory. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and with thy great Holy Spirit to bless
towards us.
And that we are made members in corporate to the midst of the body of thy Son, the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom. And we humbly beseech thee, O heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ our Lord,
to whom be the Holy Ghost, the honor and glory,
world
without end. Amen.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. 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 Alleluia.